Inshallah, we will share some advice if we have heard that we have recited in the first raka'ah some beautiful verses where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about those who pass away and die in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentioned who mashallah will be trialed and tested, and that is part of being alive. None of us that are alive today can say that we have not been trialed or tested in our life. All of us, we went through certain difficulties in our lives, alhamdulillah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a manual, something that we should connect with. And today, as I've discussed with my learners, I said, the book of Allah is not something that is just dead. It's not something that you should look at just as a mushaf, as a book, like any other book. The book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very much alive. And I challenge all of us, ourselves first, and I challenge them as youngsters. I said, today if you face any difficulty in your life, go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how? One of the ways that you can go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by reading the book of Allah. Open the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You find yourself in the difficulty anywhere. Don't think, just open the book of Allah and start reading, and you will see how Allah reveals to you answers. But because our ta'alluq and our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not so strong, that is why we face these challenges and these difficulties, and we try to solve it ourselves. And that puts stress upon ourselves, and then tomorrow we find ourselves that we're at the lowest point in our life, and now only we realize, hey, I still have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to turn to. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks so profoundly in the Quran. And start off by Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Allah speaks to the people of Iman, and that is us. Subhanallah, and this is something that we must treasure. That Allah has given us faith and Allah has given us Iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ista'inu bi sabri wa salah. Allah gives commands. Allah says, come to me and practice patience and pray to me and have patience after that. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises that when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to us. We don't have a Lord that lie, then He cannot be our Lord, He cannot be our Creator. فَإِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. Allah said that my promise is true. And when Allah says it's true, He will fulfill that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ever ever leave us in a place whereby we would feel that we have no one to turn to. Allah promised that if you turn to me, I'll be there for you. I will respond to you. Just come. Allah promised through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where Allah commands him to say, إِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي أَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. That if my servants speak and ask about me, tell them, Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say, Muhammad, you give them an answer. Allah said, Allah give the answer. I am near to them, Muhammad. Tell them, Allah say, Allah is close to them. And closeness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's no need for Allah to explain it. But Allah know humankind. Allah say, let me explain to you what closeness means. وَنَحْنُ مِي Allah أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ. I am closer to you مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ than your jugular vein. That is how close Allah is to us. Allah, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes in detail when Allah explains to us how close He is to us. Why? To give us understanding that I am so close to you. The only thing you need to do is turn to me. I'm your Lord, Allah, I'm here for you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the people that fight in the path of Allah, they are not dead. The people that fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The world is in chaos, Jamaat al-Muslimin. The entire world, alhamdulillah, I think is the first time that I had a little bit of a breather, because now what I'm seeing, what is happening globally, and especially in the Middle Eastern countries, they're starting to speak out. They're starting to write down rods, rudud. We are not satisfied with what the enemy is doing to us. There's no way that we can look at it differently. They are our enemy. They are not friends of ours. They are not friends of the world. They are not friends of humanity. They are the khabith. They are the shayateen of this earth. They don't think nothing of humankind. How can you say that our blood is better than the blood of someone else? We are all the creation of Allah. And that is why Islam is the answer. That is why we need to look at how we live our lives. Now this introspection should take place now with us, Jamaat al-Muslimin. You know the petty things that we still fight about? Wallahi, it's by time that we give up on that. There are many great things that is happening in the world, and we need to wake up as believers and stand together and firm. And I can see it starting to happen. And you know what is the thought that comes to mind? That this is now prophesized. The prophet also spoke about this. There's going to come a time, and when this happened, Qiyamah is coming. And my hair is starting to rise. when I said Qiyamah, I'm like, Allahu Akbar. Jamaatul Muslimin, are we ready? Are we ready? Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is going to come. The Mahdi is going to come. Who is going to be the army of the Mahdi in Isa? Are we ready? It's going to happen. No matter how the world wants to look at it, we don't care how they look at it, because Allah says so. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam says so. But are we ready? You know, I was thinking about fitness. Oh, ya Allah, imagine we must run from here to Joburg in a fight. I don't know. You know, am I going to be fit enough? Are we preparing ourselves? We're preparing, yes, mashallah, with our studies. But mentally, physically, are we speaking to our children about this? Do they know the severity of what is going to come? The Dajjal is going to come. You need to be prepared for this. Allah speaks about this. And Allah says, those mujahideen that's dying, let them not die in vain. They're dying for a certain message. They're dying for something great, and that is Al-Aqsa. How many of us are making dua for Al-Aqsa every day of our lives? Every moment that we can, we have to. It's part of our creed, it's part of our aqidah. The mujahideen are dying, and I call them mujahideen because they are mujahideen. They are not the scum of the earth that people want to try to picture and place within the hearts of people. No, they are the mujahideen. They are the people that fight for haq. They are the people that stand for Aqsa. And we need to recognize that, and we need to give them recognition for that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I'm coming, there's so much I want to say, but it's between Maghrib and Isha, everybody wants to have a nice meal. Inshallah ta'ala. So, the hadith of Nu'man ibn Bashir, he mentions that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the example of the believers in their mutual love. Look at how Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam speak. He don't just speak about believers, he say, the example of the believers in their mutual love. That is what we, this is who we are. We need to love each other all the time. We need to feel for each other. What I want for myself, I want for my brother, for my sister, for my child, for somebody else's child, for my grandmother, grandfather, and others also, elders, whoever they are in the world, Muslim or non-Muslim. But we're speaking about believers here, and Allah and Rasulullah connects with the believers' love. Mutual love for each other. Example of the believers in their mutual love. And then mercy and compassion. That is who we are. We should have mercy and compassion towards each other. How come we don't have mercy? Somebody do something, we hate them for their entire lives. Because of something small that they've done, this is not the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam connects with us as believers, mercy and compassion. Shower people with mercy and compassion. If you do it in this world, the angels in the samawat, and Allah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't call it the angels, he said, the creation in the samawat, meaning the creation that we know about, who's the angels, and those whom we don't know about, they will show mercy upon you. We want to receive mercy? Show mercy. You want kindness? Show kindness. You want compassion? Show compassion. This is the way of the believers. Right? So here, Isa a.s. say, they are the example. Shown to each other, mutual love, mercy, compassion. Right? They are to each other like a body. They are like a body. When one limb aches, the entire body responds by sleeplessness and fever. How can our lives carry on normal now in this situation? It can't be normal. If your small little toe of your body is knocking against a wall now, can you imagine what will happen? Are you going to say, okay, it's only my toe, my pinky toe that's paining. My body is released from that. That pinky can handle it itself. It's not going to happen. Our entire body is going to feel that pain and ache and fever. We're going to take pain tablets. We're going to do whatever we can. And that is the believers. Our brothers, sisters, children are being murdered and massacred. What are we doing, Jamaatul Muslim? Are we doing something about it? This is for us to introspect and think about. We are the believers. We have mutual love for each other. We show kindness and mercy to each other. We think and we want for others what we want for ourselves. Look at us, sitting so beautifully, comfortable, listening to Allah's kalam and the speech of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No worries. Calm in our masjid, but other places, our people are being bombed. Masajid are being bombed. Why? Because they are Muslim. It's the only reason why. Because they are Muslim. We are Muslim. We need to stand together, inshallah. Let us be of those that when people come to us with those waswas of shaitan, because remember Allah say there's shayateen al-ins wal-jin. So there's not only the shaitan, but there's the shaitan of the humankind as well. They will come and try to split you up and separate you through simple things. Things which is not allowed in Sharia. Things which we will have differences about. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look at us with mercy through that. Because Isa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a Nabi of mercy and he came to spread mercy. But we use that mercy and we want to create rifts with each other with the merciful words of Allah and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is not how we should act as believers. We should bring people together. We must say, my brother, I disagree with you, but I love you for Allah's sake. I love you, wallahi. I'm not here because I'm not saying things because I hate you. I'm saying it because I love you. So we agree to disagree on this. But mashallah, my brother, I love you. Let us carry on with life. Because our mission and our vision and our maqsad is only one. And that is to seek the pleasure of Allah. May Allah grant us His pleasure. May Allah allow us that we can feel the pain of every single person that is going through difficulty in the world. May Allah allow us to feel that pain with them. May Allah allow us through our du'as and cries to Allah and one tear that is being shed on behalf of the difficulties of others. May Allah allow that du'a that we make to make a difference in their lives, inshallah ta'ala. And what is the difference we're waiting for? It was asked in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Mata nasrullah. The cry was being cried. When is the victory coming? Allah inna nasrullahi qareeb. Allah say, don't worry. The victory is near. It's coming, Jamaatul Muslimin. Soon bi idnillah, the victory will come. The victory will come and we will walk tahta liwa'i Sayyidina Muhammad. Under the banner of who? Of Muhammad. Under the banner of who? Muhammad. 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 Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ameena ya Rabbil Alameen. Let us have that love for him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when I say love for him, the words that has been uttered is not the words of Mawlana Wasim. It's the words of Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to feel pain if our brothers and sisters are feeling pain. Feel that pain. Inshallah ta'ala, day of Qiyamah, that brother and that child that was massacred will stand in front of you and say, oh Allah, this person is not going to go to Jahannam. Ya Allah, he is the one that made dua for me. Cry that night for me, ya Allah. Please let him enter with me into Jannah. Ameena ya Rabbil Alameen. May Allah accept. Barakumullah feekum. I love you all for the sake of Allah. And may Allah protect us always here where we are because we are blessed. And let us, because of our blessings, realize our blessings. And inshallah ta'ala, raise our hands in thankfulness and gratefulness to Allah. And when we raise our hands, Allah will accept in that side of the world that they will be victorious inshallah. Al-afu minkum. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.